दूसरे के बीच में अंतर है, उनसे ऊपर उठना है।
कांग्रेसमैन इन्वॉल्व, सम कांग्रेसमैन प्रोबेबली वर इन्वॉल्व।
84 वाला दर्द पूरा कर नहीं, ओना दे उधर नमक छिड़क दिया, नमक
587 FIR टोटल रजिस्टर हुए, उसमें से 241 FIR पुलिस ने खुद ही बंद कर दिया एज अन केस।
दिल्ली पुलिस जो है मूक दर्शन बनी रही, उसने रोकने का भी प्रयास नहीं किया, एक गोली नहीं चलाई किसी को।
द डेथ टोल ऑफ ब्लॉक 32 त्रिलोकपुरी अलोन इट्स इन फैक्ट मोर देन द डेथ टोल ऑफ जलियांवाला बाग मैसेकर।
October 31st, 1984 has gone down into the annals of history as a dark day for Indian democracy. It started with the assassination of the then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi by her two Sikh bodyguards. While the nation was mourning the loss of its Prime Minister, other sentiments were brewing elsewhere. In no time, all sentiments transpired into a pogrom that saw a brutal massacre of Sikhs all over the country. The epicenter of this human tragedy was the national capital that alone recorded more than 3,000 dead in 3 days. While the political leaders took credit for containing the riots within 3 days, the disturbing memories of the pogrom live on in the nation's consciousness even 30 years later. Several commissions were set up over the years to investigate the violence of 1984. While it was the worst ever state-sponsored mass carnage, there are some who see it as a complete failure of state machinery to contain communal tensions that flared up beyond the control of the police. There are still others who are awaiting justice as the ghosts of the past continue to haunt them. Was it state-sponsored genocide or an insensitive twist of fate where misguided patriotic rage punished an entire community for the fatal actions of two individuals? Was the police rendered ineffective by the powers of the time, or did it get absorbed in the damaged political fabric? 10 commissions and committees have come and gone, but these questions remain unanswered even 30 years after the bloody massacre. Numerous police station house officers and political leaders were indicted by various investigation committees, but almost all of them were exonerated by the Nanavati Commission, the last in the series. A host of unanswered questions have kept the bloody riots of 1984 alive in the nation's consciousness. You are watching Chapter 84.
Congressmen involved?
Some congressmen probably were involved.
But have they been? Has justice been delivered to
them?
There
is a legal process through which they have gone.
You admit some congressmen were probably involved.
Some congressmen have been punished for it.
SIT के गठन का मामला और उसके क्या terms of reference होंगे? ये अब अगली कैबिनेट मीटिंग में हम लोग
जांच करवाना चाहते हैं आप एसआईटी से या क्या करवाना चाहते हैं अभी
डिटेल कैबिनेट में रखेंगे सारा डिटेल।
प्रधानमंत्री के दावेदार हैं, उनको ये नाम सार्वजनिक करने चाहिए।
Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi admitted the involvement of some Congress leaders in the violence against the Sikhs in 1984. Akali Dal's Delhi unit's President Manjeet Singh GK says he does not want an apology but action against the culprits in the 84 pogrom. An SIT probe into the 1984 communal conflagration is part of Aam Aadmi Party's election manifesto. Manoj Mitta, co-author of When a Tree Shook Delhi, emphasizes why the pogrom that took place 30 years ago is still an incomplete story.
See, the worst affected police districts in Delhi were East Delhi, West Delhi and South Delhi, in that order. Hundreds of Sikhs were killed in these three districts in a matter of 3 days in 1984. Yet, the Nanavati Commission, which conducted the last judicial inquiry, into the 1984 carnage, did not deem it fit to indict a single police official from any of these three police districts. Such was the impunity that surrounded the 1984 issue. Now, the general reason cited by the Nanavati Commission for its reluctance to indict any of these officials was that they had already been exonerated in departmental proceedings. Now, this is the reasoning given by a former Supreme Court judge when he had been entrusted by the government under a statutory provision to conduct a fresh inquiry. A fresh inquiry because the previous inquiries had not arrived at the truth, had not done their job properly, and he cites that very lapse to get away with further impunity with regard to police complicity. Such was the farce of fact-finding done in 1984. If the casualties in 1984 were higher than in 2002, one of the glaring reasons was the complete absence of police firing throughout Delhi when hundreds of Sikhs were killed in 1984. Had there been proper fact-finding in 1984, had there been proper justice done in 1984, it is reasonable to assume that it would have served as a deterrent in the context of 1992-1993 Bombay riots, and it would have probably served as a deterrent in the context of 2002 Gujarat riots.
Cobra Post Associate Editor Ashit Dixit speaks to eight police officers present at the scene of crime in 1984. They are Shurveer Singh Tyagi, SHO Kalyanpuri, Rotas Singh, SHO Delhi Cantonment, SN Bhaskar, SHO Krishnanagar, OP Yadav, SHO Srinivaspuri, Jaipal Singh, SHO Mehrauli, SC Tandon, Commissioner of Police, and Gautam Kaul, ACP Delhi Police. The actions of these police officers have come under the scanner of various investigation committees. Cobra Post reporter also meets with Amreek Singh Bhullar, SHO Patel Nagar in 1984. In his affidavit to various commissions, Amreek Singh Bhullar had named some local leaders who were seen instigating and even leading the mob. These police officers were the eyewitnesses and they were the men in authority. In the course of conversations with these police officers, Cobra Post stumbled upon some shocking revelations. The revelations are gripping, riveting, and pathetic. Chapter 84 reveals how the guardians of our law and custodians of our faith had shed their robes of conscience and duty. The government of the time was guilty of inaction while they created the impression that the police was inactive in performing their duty. The police force had succumbed to anti-Sikh sentiments. Blank stamp papers were indeed signed and presented as affidavits praising the police officers on duty at the time. The Sikhs in Kalyanpuri were indeed disarmed before being left to the mercy of the mob and eventually killed. While news of arson and plunder bombarded the police control rooms, only 2% of the messages were recorded. Police logbooks were indeed changed to eliminate all evidence. The police did not take control of the riots in 84, partly due to fear and partly due to negligence. Dead bodies of victims were dumped in nearby areas to minimize visible damage. Congress associates were physically present in the riot zones and were seen encouraging the mob. Station house officers' repeated warnings about increasing tensions went unheard by the then Commissioner of Police. Messages were broadcast to not take any action against those shouting slogans of revenge. Some of these discoveries may have found mention in the various committees that have investigated the 84 riots. However, not a single police officer was booked for the riots that led to the brutal massacre of thousands of Sikhs in 3 days. Far from facing any punitive action, these police officers have received multiple promotions within the department and eventually given an honorable discharge. Cobra Post investigation provides the missing evidence and you are watching Chapter 84. The first witness is the East Delhi police officer under whose watch Delhi saw the severest Sikh massacre. Ironically, by his own admission, he was never called for any inquiry.